Bam. Welcome to the show tonight. Pro Se Legal School. We provide the tools. You do the punching. I'm Coach Neighbors. Welcome to the show. And tonight, we got it going on tonight. We're going to be talking about, well, how to file a complaint against the judge. That's not really what we're going to be talking about, but that's what we're going to start out talking about, and I think I have a better idea. So that's what we're going to be doing today. Before we get started doing all that, I want to... I want to throw this banner on the screen down here underneath to me here. You guys coming from Facebook, please go to this link below and give StreamYard permission to use your Facebook username. Otherwise, you show up as Facebook user when you leave a comment. So go there and do that. I'm just going to let that roll on the bottom of the screen for a couple of minutes. Welcome, and welcome to the show tonight. JD. We talk about how, you'll see what I mean when I get to the end. I think tonight's program is a little bit of bait and switch. But I think they're the bait, and y'all ass gonna have the switch. gonna have the switch. Okay, well, stick. We'll call it bait and stick, because we ain't going in with no switch. We want a stick. That way, we don't have to hit them that hard, so we can hit them a bunch of times. We don't want to knock them out. We want to make them suffer for what they put you through. So that's how that's how I So I say, like, it's time to have fun. And some of the new people in the group, I tell you to let me know when you're having fun. And what the hell does that mean? That means that you're not waking up every morning worrying about the knock on the door. Because, you know, they ass is busy over there. That's what I mean. Welcome, Gino. John. Melinda. You're welcome for my dedication. My dedication kind of is a double-edged sword sometimes for people who want to have it easy or who aren't willing to get a Facebook page or do. In my program, you got to be willing to do whatever it takes. You know, I had people telling me last week, oh, I don't do Facebook. I don't care. If you want coaching, then you need to get a page. You can tell me your name and use whatever name you want. I don't care as long as I know what that name is. Otherwise, you're not going to get in my private group. And so that's how that works. I don't coach on emails. I don't coach on my phone. You see how stinking big my hand is. My hand's too big for me to be texting people all the time. And it takes too much thinking. I work on Facebook. You can message me in Messenger the way I do this. If you're new to the program, new to the group, and new doing this, I do the coaching in Messenger. And when you get rolling and I feel like that you understand what's going on or whatever, then you can get into the group. Now, I know people get mad or whatever. I don't care. Those people who are acting like that are mad because they think they're going to get in the group so the group can help them so they don't have to do the work. That's pretty much it. But they don't realize that's not what the group is for. The group is not to help you get started. The group is not to help you, okay? The group is to teach you what you need to learn to stay in court after you get yourself to the gate. So you got to get yourself to the gate, and then the group can help you or whatever. But anyway, that's how it goes here. I make the rules, I change them, and some of you used to working with attorneys and being in a court, so you know how, you know how that goes. But in my program, the rules are going to help the majority of the people, okay? The rules will help the majority of the people. I don't take phone calls for the lawsuit packages. Even if you invest in a $1,500 package, you still have to communicate with me on Facebook. Now, if you invest in a $1,500 package, the Prosecutor Eliminate package or the online course, then our communication on Facebook, I decide if I need to call you from our communication on Facebook. Otherwise, people will be calling me all day because their time is more valuable than mine. But that's what this boils down to. Just hurry to get in the group because you want to save time and hurry up to block the sale. You want to block the whatever. You want to block. That's not what we do. That's not what we do. Well, that gets done, but that's not the goal of what we do. If you don't stop the reason why they got your shit for sale in the first place, then you're toast. So I'm just going to throw that on the table. Rushing around and hurrying are things that you did when you was in their conventional program. You know, the one they structured for you to be in while they're taking your stuff. Yeah, that program. That rushing around, all that's what you did over there. In my program, you don't need to do that because you just get the one thing done and stuck in there in their face. And if you do it right, then you're the one that's going to be running the show. So that's all I got to say about that. Now, tonight's program, yeah, that's pretty much how I do it, Belinda for JT. That's pretty much it. And some people don't like it. I had a conversation with a person yesterday that was interested in a Prosecutor Eliminating Package, and she got a little grumpy because I didn't want to hear all the stuff that she wanted to tell me what she'd been doing, what the prosecutor's doing. I don't need to hear any of that. I'm not an attorney. I don't teach people how to do conventional stuff. So we really don't go into court arguing all those things people want to tell me about. What we want to address are the state procedures that allow them to do what they're doing. For instance, in foreclosure, you know, that the registration of their deed, that's what allowed all of this to That's what allowed it all to get in. If you're looking at a criminal, there's no injured party. And this is what I tell people. I don't need to hear this criminal. I don't need to hear all that. Oh, does my package? Dude, are they attacking you? Do they have an injured party? No. Do they have damaged property? No. The government cannot be the injured party. So that pretty much that pretty much opens the door for pretty much, you know, if there's no injured party and there's no damaged property, then, you can go after them for the lies that they said if you want to and keep yourself in their conventional program until they lock your ass up or take your stuff. Or you could go after the actual people that signed to start the problem, the people that signed to rule and give your stuff away that's getting paid by the same corporation that has your deed in their office. And there's no law that says your deed needs to be in their office. So, okay, so we're getting a little off subject here. So we're going to get back on the subject. Welcome, Jen V. And Regina, we got some new people here, but they're not new to me, so very nice. So let's just get on with the reason why we're here tonight, because I know y'all didn't just come to hear me get on my wagon. So tonight we're going to review, starting out how to file a complaint against a judge. That's actually what I searched on this fancy website that one of my best friends, a computer genius, sent me this fancy website that looks up stuff that not everybody gets to find. And so we go to this website and we do a little research on filing a complaint against the judge. Then I had a new friend that I met, and it's funny how it goes. I always thought all attorneys were, but not all of them are. Some of them are good. they just, well, you know, when you start out to be an attorney, some people want to do it to help. Well, a lot of people probably want to do it to help. And then they get sucked into the corruption and the crap. And so some people spend a lot of money to learn how to help, but now they are over here and they have to do that or, yeah, so. But anyway, so those people offer advice and give me some little tidbits of nuggets to throw on the table. So I thought that we'd just talk about this. So if you need to file a complaint against a judge, I have a better idea. And I know some of you guys are already thinking, well, we're already suing the judge. No, just, you know, just stay in line and work with me here. Because we're going to get to it. So first, we're going to review what the bar members want you to do in their conventional program they structured for you while they're stealing your property or your freedom. So we're going to look at that. I'm going to refer you back to the instructional video, but this is not why we're here tonight to talk about the process that my processes and stuff. We're here to talk about what we need to do to get the judge in control. So, SPK, you can hit me up on Facebook. That's where I do the coaching. Friend me, and then we can see each other, and then we can go from there. If I'm already getting sidetracked just on the stuff that I think is more important than what I'm about to say, so I need to stay focused. Because some people showed up tonight so they hear what I said we was going to talk about. So if you need to get a judge in trouble, and this is what their stuff says. If you need to get a judge in trouble for violating the judicial code or conduct by taking jurisdiction without an injured party or damaged property. Oh, yeah, I threw that in. Then we're gonna give you some ideas how to get that done. So if you have to file a complaint against a judge on the federal level, we're going to cover where you go to do that. And we're also going to cover where you go to file it against the state judge. We're also going to talk about some of the facts that you need to consider in your complaint. So all in all, we're going to kind of overview a game plan that you can throw on the table to earn the judge's respect. So we had a team member that contacted me a few days ago to let me know that if I remember correct, she was using the proper the challenge property tax package, and she stopped several judges or whatever, and she stopped the lien foreclosure, and now they told her that they're going to send in another judge from a retired judge from another district. And that she didn't have to show up for the hearing because that judge was going to adjudicate all of the misconduct the attorneys were doing. That was funny. And she actually wanted to send me a letter. I thought she didn't need to do that. She could just tell me what they said. I don't like it when people send me stuff. So if you sent me stuff, you probably found out that I threatened to block you if you keep sending me stuff. Because I'm not an attorney. I don't want to see your shit. So, and I'm very adamant about that. Before you get started, you guys, please subscribe. Hit the like button on my videos and share them so other people can see them. So, JD, we're going to talk about what I want to talk about. So, I'm just going to leave your stuff sitting there. Okay. So, we're going to talk about what I want to talk about. And if you want to talk about this other stuff, you can just hit me up later on Facebook. That's how that goes. So the first thing they said, if you want to get a judge in trouble, is that you should file your complaint against the judge. And where they're telling you to file a complaint, they're saying, my friend suggested that the complaints be filed. Now, I didn't tell my friend really what I'm going to tell you guys. My friend suggested that we file our, no, JD, you know I have a program, man, and you're interrupting my program because I can't go on with my stuff. So if you want to be a butthead about it, then I'll just block you next time and I won't have to deal with you, because obviously you're not here to learn what I have to say and what other people are here to learn. So if you can just hang on and chill, thank you for the super sticker, but I'm not posting no more of your stuff here until I get done with my thing. Thank you. Now, my friend suggested that we file complaints, if you're looking at federal court, with the clerk of the Court of Appeals for the Federal Circuit in which the judge works. And I was like, I never thought about filing a complaint there. And they also suggested that we use the the Court of Appeals complaint form, which doesn't allow you to address anything. Now, they said you should write if you Google this to learn how to do it. It's so funny. They tell you that you need to write a letter of complaint that includes your name, your address, the name of the judge, the conduct that you believe violated the judicial code, and any supporting documents. So they want me to, I'm going to file a complaint against the judge for violating my rights or due process, whatever. And what they tell you to do is to file a letter of complaint. So I'm thinking a letter of complaint's not going to have the case number on it or even be filed in the case. They're going to leave it up in the front office with all of the complaints. They're probably leaving it in that round file cabinet that's right at the next to the desk that you use your foot to open the lid on. That's the one they're probably going to file your letter of complaint in. And they say you should complain with the board or the Commission for Justice Judicial Conduct. To complain or with the board or the Commission for Judicial Conduct for the state judges that need to be handled. So this is funny. So you can ask the clerk. It says right on their thing, you can ask the clerk for information on how to file a complaint against the judge. And then the clerk is going to give you the information that I just read, where you will be able to learn how to file a letter of complaint. It's not a complaint. It's a complete play on words, and their system is pretty much that anyway. So here's this is good. It says, please take note, filing a complaint against a judge is not appropriate if you disagree with the judge's decision or ruling. Okay. So now you see, this is their conventional program that you are in, that they structured for you. And you can see right here that it's not structured to help you. Instead of filing a complaint, you're filing a letter of complaint. You think it's a complaint, but you don't see what they give you on that form. It says letter of complaint. And it says that you should add evidence that the judge has engaged in misconduct or disability that affects his ability to perform their duties impartially and ethically. Well, wait a minute. So I'm thinking the judge is being paid by the state. The state is the one that committed real estate deed fraud to get your deed in their office. And the registration of that deed allowed the first illegal lien to be put against your property. And the first illegal lien was the mortgage lien because, like we said in several videos, if there were several people who owned the property, all of the owners would have to be present to sign that lien, right? So the fact that the alleged lender accepted your signature on the lien proves that you owned it already. So, yeah, all of those, yeah. So there is some stink right there. Well, no, we don't ask for no judicial review. If we were going to file a complaint, we just file a complaint. When you ask for a judicial review, in my opinion, and this is my legal advice, JD, you can call it whatever you want to. This is guys, coach, neighbors, advice. In my opinion, when you file a judicial review, any of that administrative stuff, is administrative stuff, okay? If you continue to stay in their conventional program, and that's what you would be doing. No offense, Jen, but that's in their conventional program. You know, I will throw your own shit in the yard. I'm just saying. Because that program is structured to beat your ass down and give them several opportunities to kick your butt out the door. So we're about to get real up in here. My suggestion, if you need to force the judge to respect you, my suggestion, in addition to what you're already doing here, my suggestion is to add the Court of Appeals for the Federal Circuit where the judge works to your lawsuit. How's that sound? Oh, think about it. So if these people are the ones that's responsible for getting up in the judge's face when the judge is screwing up. Oh, wait. So let's just break this down. When the judge signs on to take a case without an injured party or damaged property. Okay. And the judge don't have jurisdiction. So when the judge is getting paid by the state who committed real estate deed fraud to get control over your property, so then the judge has a conflict of interest. Oh, wait. In my program, you learn how to add the state, the judge, and the attorney, or prosecutor, it don't matter, they're all names, right to your, So now what happens? I had a lady ask me today, so, what is your clients? I don't have any clients. I don't do this. I hide out somewhere and coach people using my stuff. And you know what? If you watch the updated instructional videos that outline the steps that you have to do, adding the state, adding these people to the counterclaim if you have time, or to a state filing to stop the state process. If you watch the updated instructional videos, no, I'm not talking about all 55 of them. I have people complain about that. I gave a lady her money back today. I didn't want to hear it no more. This is a legal school. Here you have the opportunity to learn how to personalize your documents. You have the opportunity to learn how to structure these documents. You have the opportunity to learn how to make your own stuff. But you know what? A lot of people here are only worried about one thing: stopping a sale. Okay, I take that back. There are some people here that are coaches that have started their own business and are leaning toward that. But the majority of the small-time people here, I have to remind them that you're not here for that reason. You're here to address why they got to do the sale, okay? Back at the gate, okay? You have to bring your fire at the gate or you are not going to have any luck getting anything done. Now, I went over just a few quick thingies why the judge don't have jurisdiction. There's no injured party, no damage of property. The judge is being paid by the corporation that committed real estate deed fraud to take control of your of your property. Yeah. So now if the judge has been added to the counterclaim, you can do a counterclaim. You can add the judge to the counterclaim if you have time. If you don't have time, then you want to go ahead and and add the judge to your state lawsuit that you're going to file first. And I know everybody, there's so many videos. No, dude, if you understand what we're doing here, you'll see how easy this is. I mean, it's easy from where I'm sitting, okay? You file your state court action against them fools or your counterclaim. They're not going to be able to answer it. They can't answer to my stuff. I'm talking crap, but everybody here, Regina, some of the other people have been using my stuff, and they can't answer to it. And so when you get your lawsuit filed in federal court, this is the new update thing that we're going to be adding. What we're telling people to do, I mean, what I would do, I would demand the federal court judge order settlement hearings. Why? Because they did not survive the beatdown that you gave them on the state court level. They did not answer. They cannot answer. So they have no standing to answer in federal court if they couldn't say shit over there. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Oh, but the federal court judge, yeah. Well, the federal court judge don't get his head out to his ass. Come on now. No, there ain't no for an answer up in up in here. No, so there's no. The other thing is to go pack your shit. Well, you ain't ready to do that, I don't think. If you are, then you should have saved your money to store yours. Okay, sorry. Okay, so I goof around, but you know if you're using my stuff that I don't play. Yeah, Jen, you're taking the long way around, hun. no record or consent or contract to administer. No, they have no law that says that your deed should be registered in their office. So you should be able to ask them and have them give you your deed back, but they don't want to do that. So most people use the property, remove property tax package to address this problem. But here's the thing. Here's the thing, and I'm just going to tell you right now. Here's the thing. I could say, oh, you need this one. You need that one. You need that one to do this. You don't. You just need one, and you need to learn how to freaking use it. I'm serious. So if I'm in foreclosure, and I got them butts backed up against the wall and moved this stuff over to federal court, and now I'm ordering a federal court judge to come settlement hearings, well, what is it I want? You need to be telling the federal dude, I need to have them deliver my deed like they're supposed to. Oh, wait, that's also a federal law. You're a federal judge. You can order them to deliver my damn deed to my house like you could, right? And then I'm thinking you might need them to have them call a credit reporting agent and correct those lies that they told them that jammed up your credit score. Yeah. Oh, and don't forget the legal team. Okay, the legal team need to be paid. Okay, and this is what I would tell the judge. I'm not up here asking for millions of dollars. I mean, I was. Okay, but if y'all get my deed delivered, okay, we can work on that. Okay, but my legal team got a lot of work in this, and they need to be paid. And I'm thinking $5 million. y'all know who the legal team is, right? Now, I told y'all to tell them fools that your legal team is over there, somewhere over there. tell them your legal team is hanging out with the lender. You know that imaginary lender that's foreclosing on on your property that didn't sign anything or have nothing to do with anything? Oh yeah, the lender done a charge off and Okay, that I think we're heading to another hour session. So yeah, I'm thinking, So here we learn from the facts, and this is what I'm trying to teach some people. We learn from the facts. The facts that I learned today. This is where you file your complaint. Well, if I'm going to file a complaint there, then I need to sue their asses to make them straighten the hell up. You're learning how to look at this a different way, okay? Because number one, y'all know nothing's going to get done waiting for the judge who's getting paid by the same people that's trying to steal your stuff. Oh, yeah, Regina's all up in, And they can't. They can't answer to it because it's facts. It's not their stupid case law or statutes. Oh, wait, their statutes, the foreclosure statute or the criminal statute that they're using against you, it's not a valid law. It doesn't have the three elements that the Constitution says. No, I'm not going to make you go look it up again. It doesn't have an acting clause, doesn't have a title, doesn't have a body. Those are the three things that have to be present for something to be a valid law. So the foreclosure statute is not a valid law. Therefore, the court don't have jurisdiction. That's all good, Robert. On the conventional side, we don't ask for nothing. We just sue their asses. The only thing we ask for is that deed be delivered according to the law. That's what we ask for. Defraud. That's absolutely true. Now, one of the other things I want to tell you guys too is, you know, when you invest in my package, is you're not getting this package all ready to go. Okay, it's the fire's in there. You need to personalize it. Now, since we learned how to do the 42 USC 1980, so now we're going after them for the state's everyday process and procedures. Everything's the same. A little bit different with the facts. I mean, for instance, the foreclosure lawsuit, there's more banking stuff in it to make them go sit down because they don't want people to know. That's pretty much it. The 42 USC, the lawsuit for credit cards was structured from the foreclosure lawsuit. The lawsuit for property tax was structured. Now the property tax does have some stuff legal, mathematical stuff in it, but pretty much everything is structured from that 42 USC 1983 civil rights package that we have to add the state and then the players or whatever too. And so if you get the credit card lawsuit package and you see some words in there that have to do with foreclosure, don't think that I'm trying to scam you or whatever. It's just words that I missed. Okay. If it doesn't have to do with the credit card, then you just take it out. If there's credit card stuff that fits in there, then you put it in. That's how you do it. I don't have staff to change everything and the things that we're learning, I'm learning as we go. And oh, we should have did that first and this over here second. But at the end of the day, people are getting stopped. People are still in their house and are not in jail. They're getting stopped. And I guarantee you, that the stopping is not because we had to change and add a period or because the grammar or because there was a word from the foreclosure thing in there. Nobody's going to be taking the time to go over that. Dude, They're going to be concerned about how to get their butt off of the case. And they're going to have trouble getting people to help them because, well, yeah, no one else wants to really help them because they're all doing the same shit. So, and by the time they see that what you're doing over here, no, they don't want none of it. Yeah, no, there's no pretender lender. There's just third-party debt collectors that are taking your stuff. John, they say they want you to lower the amount. No, John. So I don't tell people what to do, but I think tonight's live stream was pretty powerful because now you have another option. You can punch a judge in the face. So if the judge says he's not going to give you 5.5, if it was me and the judge said he's not going to give me 5.5, then I would just add the judge and let them know that I'm going to file a claim against the judge because if the judge is going to say that, the judge should have some kind of reason why we're going to do that or why I'm not going to do that. Whatever. Yeah. So that would be, yeah. Oh, wait. So if the judge don't have jurisdiction to do that, so why would the judge? So, John, are you talking federal? And I wouldn't tell him just to lower the amount and do whatever. I would tell him that they need to deliver my damn deed to me and order him to do that. That's what I would do. Because the money, there's never any money. There's never any money. You get your deed out of their office and then I don't know for sure because I'm not that smart. But if you get your deed out of their office, I'm wondering how they would be able to verify that there was a mortgage lien against your property. Yeah, I have offered a paid letter that I'm putting together. I'm working on a package that people can use to challenge them for the illegal mortgage crapola before you're in default. Yeah, and it starts out with the offer to pay letter that outlines the statute that forces them to deliver the original instrument of indebtedness if they're going to call in the loan. And so the idea is to use this letter to force them into controversy. If you've just entered into foreclosure situation, the letter could be used to jam up their future filing the foreclosure against you. And the way this would work in my mind is that I would serve the offer to pay letter to them. The offer to pay letter has all these fancy stuff that I put together. And pretty much says that you're willing to pay as long as they follow this statute here, which is the law, that mandates they have to provide the original instrument, which is the promissory note. We already know they don't have that son of a gun because it was gone a long time ago. Now, the concept here is that once you serve them and you have verification that they received your offer to pay letter, if they want to jam you up for missing a payment or whatever, if you're in foreclosure, then you can use this to let them know there's no controversy. You haven't decided not to pay them. You're offering to pay them as long as they're providing with you what the law says they have to provide. So it kind of throws them in, put them in a little bit of a situation. And I included this offer to pay letter. I'm including, I think I included it already. I'm going to include it. I think I put it in the file for the online course. So the people who invest in the online course will have an opportunity to take advantage of this offer to pay letter. And that's where we're at with it now. Now, once I get 10 or 12 people, or maybe even 5 people using it, or 3, I don't think anybody, I don't know how they're going to respond to it. Then it, I may open the letter up and make a and put it on my website as just the letter. It's going to be a little expensive when it works because it's totally badass. But that's what we're working on right now. I want people in the online course to use the letter. And if you get an online course, you have all the other stuff to back you up if the letter, you know, doesn't move them fast enough. So, and that's the idea right now. I want to make sure it works and accomplish what we need in the time frame that we have to do. So that's kind of what we're going to do that. So anybody interested in that offer to pay letter can hit me up later or get in the invest in the online course, and you'll get a copy of it now. I haven't decided to open it up yet. I want to let the online course people use it, and so that I can kind of get a feel on how they're going to try and respond to it. You could, L.A. Rhonda. That's anything that's outside of their conventional program. I don't know about the impeachment process or any of that. So I just like to keep it simple. Because, you know, basically on the state court, you just need the judge to step down. And the judge is going to have to, I don't know, from the judge has to recuse himself. There's no, there's no other. When you add the judge to their own, their own action, I don't know. The judge has to recuse himself. The judge can't hire anybody. So I don't know. I don't know about 1866, Daniel, or what that means. I don't know what switch around thing. Nothing's gone. We are just finding more to do. So, I don't know, Robert, what this has to do with what we're talking about tonight. JD, you can go to my website and see what I have, man. Oh. Thank you, Belinda. I might make you my assistant coach. Okay, let me check here, make sure I didn't miss anything. So in our program, we sue them for the day-to-day procedures they use to violate your due process and line you up in their administrative court to be violated again. If you don't sue them for their procedures, the procedures are going to continue until they're throwing your shit out in the yard. And this is why I don't need to hear all of the stuff that people think that I need to hear before I can tell them if the package is the right package. Because that's not the way this works. That's not the way it works with me. OK, Okay, you have to go to the website and take a look at the options that you have and decide, because you're your own attorney. I'm not an attorney. I don't have clients. You have to go there, decide what you think is going to work for you, and if you have questions for me, then you can call me or whatever. After you invest in a lawsuit package, then you have to take it over to Facebook for the coaching, because I don't coach on my phone. And I have some people that are, a couple people that are smarter than me. And so they decide they're going to make me coach on my phone by keep calling me and ignoring the fact that I'm telling them I don't coach on my phone. So after I tell you the second time, you won't be able to call me anymore because I'm going to block your ass. So that's just how I do that. I like to be open and right up front with everybody. So you have ample opportunity to make the right decision. I'm very strict with my cell phone rules, because if I wasn't, I would not get a stinking thing done all day. I would be answering the phone, telling people to go to the instructional video. Okay, I had one person get mad at me, and that person tried to call me, and I messaged them. Look, I don't take the call for, you know, oh, I found it. It was right here in my face. That's what... All right, so I'm like, some people think their time's more valuable than mine. But the thing is, if you don't put the time in, you're not going to learn what you need to know. You're not going to know the words that you need to be saying to those fools when you're talking to the clerk or the judge. We filed a lawsuit to address the state's procedures, like, you know, registering your deed, the registration of your deed when there's no law that says your deed needs to be registered and that registration allowed to, you know, yeah. We went over all that. If you guys are interested in my program, the updated instructional videos outline the new things that we've learned and added when we switched over to the 42 USC package and then switched all the packages over to that. Okay, the updated. Now, you still need to watch the other video, the instructional video for the lawsuit package. You still need to watch it, but you need to understand, we don't file jurisdiction crap. We don't do, we never did affidavit of state citizenship as anything that we thought would help control them in the beginning or nothing. We don't do anything that requires a judge to rule. That's pretty much it. I'm going to file jurisdiction. Oh, that requires a state judge to rule. Or the eviction judge. Or whatever judge you're in. Yep. And besides, if you do the program right, you're already suing the state, the judge, and the prosecutor or the attorney. And now you're dragging their happy asses over to federal court, where you're going to order the federal court to make them sit their happy asses down and deliver your deed to you and pay your, because they had no standing, because they couldn't reply to nothing, to the beatdown that they got in the state court level. Yeah, I know. They're going to keep sending it all around. That's why we just sue them. We don't waste any time. Yeah, Daniel, I don't know about the Civil Rights Act of 1966. What I'm using right now is working pretty good for me. So you can use whatever you want. I had the website address on the thing there, Mr. 617 Swag. I don't help. You got to help yourself by going to my website at winningcourtnow.com and getting what you need, and then going to YouTube channel and watching the instructional videos. So the updated instructional videos, so you learn how to stop the state court process and get rolling. Gonna put the banner back on here. There you go. Yeah, I need to change that because we're pro se legal school now. So legal school means you guys got to learn some stuff. I'm not here to give you all answers and tell you what to do. At the end of the day, I had one lady that felt like she needed help. And I told her, you know, maybe you would be better at this than the person that you want to help you. Now, that being said, I have a couple of people that invested in the online course. And they had a person that, a family member that they're using to take the course. And that family member is communicating with me just like I would if the course was sold to them. And I'm helping them learn how to do what they need to do. So if you don't have time to do all of this, but you have the resources to invest to protect your property, you can invest in an online course. I have several property management companies that are using the online course to train their in-house strike team to handle the business. And the cool thing about this is that the team that they train can stop foreclosures or are learning to stop, can stop foreclosures in any state. Because what we do is jam up the state and drag the happy asses over to federal. So, and all the documents that you file in state are federal. They don't like it, but they can't stop you from doing but they can't file federal. They can't file state in federal. So, yeah, that jams them up. Pretty good at the gate. We do a lot of gate jamming around here. So anybody facing these problems need to head over to the website and click on the product page. That would be the easiest thing to do. Click on the product page, and then all the products are in little squares line right there where you can see them all on one page. And then you can decide what you need to take care of the problem that you have, that you're about to not have. I want to thank you guys for the privilege of sharing your time. Make sure you subscribe and share my videos so other people see them. And I'll see you guys in the next live stream. And keep punching.